Every day marks a new beginning, and a new beginning always embarks on a new journey. A journey that is full of passion, struggles, but ultimately leads to victory. Hello everyone, this is Sharmandrila Paul, welcoming you to yet another episode of Meet the Makers. And today, we have a person whose passion has made him what he is today, Mr. Vaibhav More. So before we start, I just would like to ask you about your journey, about you started 17 years ago and you have an avid experience in this field. So how do you see yourself today?
I remember painting on the walls with the chalk, and my mamaji used to help me, you know, draw things on the, because we never had like canvases and drawing books at that time. So we did not have the privilege. Like, my family would encourage me to do what I'm doing. And the first time I felt that I could do something in this field was at the age of 14. I guess I was in 7th grade or 8th grade, and one of my father's friend is a fellow professor of microbiology. He wanted to become an artist.
Okay.
He wanted to go to a fine art school. And he happened to visit our house, and he saw me drawing all these things, and he asked my father how, you know, he's really good. Can you show me a few more of his drawings? And I showed him a bunch of drawings, and he was very excited. And that's when he advised my father to take me to visit JJ School of Arts.
Okay.
Because that is where he wanted to go. And so I visited JJ School of Arts, and I went to Jahangir Art Gallery, and suddenly,
you made up your mind.
I made up my mind. I knew this is what I can do better, and this is something that I would love to pursue as a career. I did not know what would happen in future. 5 years of learning fine arts, applied arts, was really an eye-opener. And throughout that 5 years of education, I started working. I started doing internships. And that's when I realized how beautiful this entire field is. Coming out of JJ School of Arts, it was a different experience, because I was, I can say, 50% prepared for what kind of challenges would be thrown at me in the industry. Industry itself, coming back to our industry, is always upgrading itself. So the education pattern can never keep up with the kind of trends that keep changing in the industry. Since 1999, I've been working as a professional. So I started working as a web designer, also as a HTML programmer. I was doing digital illustrations, kind of semi-digital illustrations. So right from working as a illustrator for Times of India as an intern, to designing architectural models for architects, to doing screen printing, and also to do some freelance advertising work. So these were the avenues that were available at that time.
You said that in the 7th grade, you almost made up your mind. 7th grade, those years are the basic foundation years of somebody, what they wants to be, or they have a certain mindset. So was it difficult, or did it change over the years?
It's a very good question, because when I was in 7th grade, I knew nothing about the creative field as a profession. It is just that I just loved drawing, you know, drawing and painting. I just thought I'll become a painter, and my people will buy my paintings. So because that was my skill set and that was my understanding. But as I progressed and I understood that this form of art can be explored in various mediums, and in my case, I started expressing my feelings when I learned animation. So for me, I think I never thought I'll become an animator or an animation director. But my basic is still the same. I still draw my frames. Only thing is, this time I have to draw a lot of frames, you know, to tell a story. Now I'm doing it for a purpose. So now I've got a definite goal. So I can stylize my work accordingly. And it gives me an opportunity to explore myself, within myself.
So parents these days, they want their children to be like doctors, engineers, or somebody who is earning a lot of money within a very short span of time, or an MBA. So did that ever happen to you, or has your education framed or channelized you in a way that, no, these are the finer forms of things in life that we really need to hold on to?
Yeah, just to add a little humor to this question.
Sure.
My wife is a doctor.
Oh, great.
I was fortunate enough that, you know, my father understood at my very early age that he is exceptional or is good in something else besides study. Of course, you should not ignore your study.
Definitely.
But a kid should be given choice to explore his passion, because every person is passionate about something. I think the times are changing. In future, I think there will be a lot of people who would be, you know, allowing their children to do whatever they want to do and explore themselves as much as possible.
So since you said that your foundation was very strong, I was just reminded of that line from Three Idiots, ki bachcha kabil bano, kamyabi jhak maar ke aa jayegi. So do you also have that same formula or mindset?
Yeah, of course. Like you mentioned about Aamir Khan and his I happened to meet him when he made Tare Zameen.
Oh, great.
And you know, that's exactly my story. You know, I had dyslexia.
Oh.
You know, I couldn't calculate. I still can't calculate things without a calculator.
Same with me.
Yeah. When I saw that film, you know, that it actually addressed my issue. And even like you mentioned about Three Idiots, like Kabil Bano. You know, don't run behind success, just run behind excellence. I think that's what he said. Even today, and I'm maybe I'm a restless person by nature, and I always want to do something better than that I've done yesterday, without thinking of what the result is going to try to.
So you have done a lot of things, from caricature to screen printing to web designing, and then now animation. How has this transformation been? And if I'm not wrong, you didn't have any formal education or formal training in animation. So how did you decide, okay, this is my field and I want to be an animation director or an animator?
Yeah, the question is very good. The answer will be a little long. So my base education is illustration, because I specialized in illustration. Unfortunately, JJ School of Art still doesn't have an animation course. In 1998-99, we had no exposure to animation. So I had to choose illustration as a beginning of my career. I really loved doing illustration. And then I went to, the mobile phone applications had just launched and a lot of things were coming up, you know. So I was employed with Reliance Mobiles, so I designed one of the first.
And they were the first ones to come up with
the color, color screen and the icons and all that. So I was fortunate enough to be part of that team to design that. So much of my experience, I felt that I still need a little bit more space to explore myself, and animation just happened to be like the right medium for me, because it's a combination art. For me, I think animation is one of the most difficult form of arts as compared to other arts, according to me. And when I worked with MTV, I was doing motion graphics for them. During that time, I kind of understood how animation works, and the new softwares were coming up, and it was a playground for us.
Okay.
Working under Cyrus Oshidhar, one of the amazing creative directors and guiding light for MTV. And once I was confident that I could do better as I progressed, I decided that I would be an animation director. And right now we are doing ad films for various advertising.
I just saw that Vodafone Zoomy Zoomy ad, and I really liked that.
I did a couple of Vodafone Zoomy ads. We did the FIFA.
The FIFA one, that's one.
And we did the Vodafone jingle for last Christmas. So it was a good experience, thanks to O&M and the creative team. And this medium really gives you that opportunity to get into the skin of any character and become that character for a while.
Founding Vaibhav More Films, how was that leap?
Yeah.
Was it difficult? I'm sure it has been difficult, but you made it through.
In the year 2007 and 2008, when I was employed with MTV India, I got an opportunity to work with MTV International. MTV Middle East was launching their new channel. and I was one of the fortunate ones to be invited there to be part of the launch team. It was a bit difficult to go to Middle East because the culture, the language, the people, the trends, everything was very different and alien for me. I still remember the day when my boss called me in the cabin and told me like, Yalla, what you're doing? And they said, yeah, you're working too much. And when I sat back and I analyzed and I studied my work, and there was a moment where like a spark in my head where I just thought, you know, I'm just working for a brand right now. Why can't I be one of the brands? And it didn't seem impossible. It just that I never thought of it. And the moment it struck my mind, this is a funny story that, you know, I came back after a year. I decided that I'll take 6 months. For 6 months, I will not work. I will not join any place. I'm just going to take a freelance job and try to do as good as possible within my limitations.
Yeah.
And I'll see in those first 6 months if I am able to survive and do good, you know. So those first 6 months, trust me, I was so busy with my work. You know, there was not a single day I could take off. Those 6 months were
epiphanic for you.
Like mind blowing. I wish I can, if I go back in time and I want to experience something, I would experience those 6 months. Because I felt so confident about myself. I still think that was one of the best decisions that I took. And I wanted to come up with a name for my company.
Yeah.
And there's an interesting story I'll tell you. So the best advice I could do is...
keep yourself as a brand.
Yeah, so, but I couldn't do that also because Vaibhav Studios was already there. Vaibhav Kumbresh had already opened Vaibhav Studios.
Has already taken your name.
So, sir, you have taken my name. So...
I'm sure he's watching.
Yeah. So what I did was, I went to Vaibhav Studios. I showed him some of my work. I'm sure he doesn't remember that. And I asked him like, ki sir, main company ka naam kya rakhun? बहुत सोचा तो ही सेड कि सर आप खुद का ही नाम रख दो ना तो आई सेड यू टेकन माय नेम नो ऑलरेडी सर आप यू व्हाई डोंट यू कीप इट वैभव मोरे स्टूडियोज और वैभव मोरे फिल्म्स आई सेड या वैभव मोरे फिल्म्स सो दैट इज द स्टोरी ऑफ माय वैभव मोरे फिल्म्स इन 2009 समर आई फॉर्म्ड वैभव मोरे फिल्म्स एंड सिंस देन आई एम वर्किंग अंडर दैट ब्रांड.
I just wanted to ask, this is a little off track that I'm going. I've always seen you in this attire. Like, I went to Anifest, and then, and your picture with this Vaibhav More Films, that is also your logo.
Yeah.
I just want to know the secret behind that.
Secret is actually, there's no secret. It's just that, you know, if you see my promos, if you see my ad films, always colorful.
Yeah. Very vibrant.
So you know, I keep my the good colors only for my work. And you know, my wife keeps asking me, why don't you wear colors, you know. So I don't know, I just feel very comfortable wearing black because you know, black is a color that absorbs everything, and if you keep anything against black, it stands out. So I think I want to become that background where everything stands out. Coming back to the logo, you know, Vaibhav More Films had two or three logo options, and we used to do a lot of gymming. I had a lot of gym partners, you know, and every time we would pose for a selfie or something, it'll always go that. So that kind of became an identity, and I thought, why not just make fun of myself? Rohan, he's part of my team, and he designed the character, like he designed the model. And we just looked at it and laughed and said, okay, let's keep it.
Yeah. Okay.
So yeah, and nothing else. There's no signature to my clothing. It's just simple. Harems, you go to Goa and you buy harems.
So anybody who wants to follow Mr. More's style statement, please have a watch.
Yeah,
this.
Yeah. But it's copyrighted now.
Where do you think the indie animation industry is currently placed right now?
As of now, according to me, I think Indian animation industry overall is doing very well if you compare to the previous years in terms of the amount of investments that are done in animation recently are much better, and future looks very bright, which I think we should continue to create the independent content. We need more independent production houses to create their own IPs and create a mark and an identity for India.
You were talking about IP, so I would just round off this with asking, do you have any plans of creating IPs?
I can't say we are planning something to do, but we want to explore the IP sector. So I think I would love to be part of that game somewhere in near future. And
fingers crossed. Every good things must come to an end. Please like, share and comment, and look forward to the next episode of Meet the Makers. This is Sharmin Rullapol signing off.